Now that we have understood why we need nonlinear devices, let us first discuss some of the nonlinear devices that we know. So next topic that we are going to see is single port nonlinear devices, okay, or it's two terminal nonlinear devices. And let's move on to the two port gradually. Okay, so what does it mean, single port nonlinear devices? So first, a well-known single port nonlinear device is a diode, and this is the symbol of the diode. This is VD, diode voltage across it, and ID is a diode current, let us say. Okay, see, the exact representation, device level representation of the diode is something you would have learnt in your device courses. It's essentially a P-N junction, which is mostly a P plus N junction, a semiconductor, which is mostly silicon. Okay, and you have this depletion region and all these concepts, but we will not be using it for the circuit course. So what we'll be using is, we'll use the voltage current relationship that is derived out of the PN junction, from your basic device course. So the voltage current relationship of the diode or the nonlinear element in this case is given as ID is equal to I naught into exponential of VD by VT minus 1. Okay, this is what it is. So first of all, why it is exponential? It is exponential because mainly the current flow in diode or any kind of PN junctions is mostly diffusion current, and diffusion current you will always have exponential relationship, because diffusion current depends on the gradient of the carriers, and carrier profile itself is exponential, and you take a derivative of an exponential, it is going to give you another exponential behavior. Okay, so this is what it is. And so now what do we do? We try to find out, we try to define all these parameters. So first of all, ID is the diode current, VD is the diode voltage that we have defined it earlier, and I naught is a reverse saturation current, which is a strong function of temperature. Okay, and VT is again KT by Q. K is the Boltzmann constant, Q is electron charge, and T is the temperature. Of course, it's a strong function of temperature, which is approximately equal to 25 millivolt, and this is called thermal voltage. Okay. So what else is left? Let us plot this behavior. Of course, it is non-linear, so you cannot expect a linear relationship. So how this relationship looks like, IV relationship. So let's say this is I and this is V, or rather ID and VD. Okay, by the way, this value of I naught will be approximately in the range of 10 raised to minus 18 to 10 raised to minus 12 amps. Okay, what I mean by this is somewhere around 30 or octo to somewhere around pico amps. Okay, so yeah, coming back to this value, I mean this graph. So essentially, you start from zero as VD increases. As long as you are reaching somewhere around 25 millivolt, you are not going to get any kind of response from this particular plot. But there is always a value that is defined for a diode. In case of silicon diode, it's somewhere around 0.7 volt or 0.65 to 0.7 volt, and that is the cut-in voltage of the diode, and beyond which the current starts to increase exponentially, and below that the current is very, very, very small. okay, or rather it, you can even assume it to be a zero current, okay, but actually it is not zero, but still you can, you know, fairly assume so. So beyond this cut-in voltage, current starts to increase exponentially, and before this value current is almost zero. And you go for negative voltages, what can you expect? You go for negative VD. You know that this exponential becomes significantly smaller as you go beyond, you know, 3 VT or 5 VT, and you will have only minus I naught remaining. Okay, and it has to pass through origin, because this device, all devices what we are discussing are mostly passive. If it is passive, then their I into V should be always greater than zero. So it should either lie in the first quadrant or the third quadrant. It cannot go into second or fourth quadrant, right? So this value is I naught, right? And of course, this is in milliampere scale and this is in picoampere scale, because I cannot show it, you know, this much variation. I naught is in terms of picoamperes, right? And this is of course will be in terms of milliampere, much larger current, forward current, and reverse current is very, very smaller. This is the behavior of the diode itself, right? So this is all about how the diode behaves, or what is the nonlinear function that is describing a diode. Okay, so what do? If we encounter diode in some circuit, right? Say for example, I have something like some kind of voltage V, and then some resistance R, and some the diode here, and this is VD, and the current flowing here would be ID. Okay, if I have a situation like this, what would I say? What is the current flow through the diode? So current through the diode is nothing but I naught into exponential of VD by VT. Okay, and if this V is much larger, okay, much larger than VT, you know, of course positive voltage, then I can neglect this particular one. Okay, this one can be neglected here if this voltage is much larger and if it is in forward pass, right? In that case, this is the ID. Okay, and ID is also equal to, I am basically applying KVL at this node, this is ID and this is also ID, so V minus VD by R. Okay, so these two equations should be solved graphically to get some relation. So let me use the same plot for that purpose. VD times ID, if I plot this expression, I am going to get this one. Ignore the, you know, reverse bias part for now, because we have neglected it. We have said the voltage is very much higher, and then I should plot this particular curve now. Okay, what is this one? If suppose I have VD to be 0, ID is going to be V by R somewhere around, sorry, V by R. And if I assume VD, ID to be 0, my value of VD is going to be V itself, right? So let me say V is somewhere here. So join these two points. This is going to be my solution. That is what it is. So this value is going to be my VD, and this value is going to be my ID for this particular circuit. Okay, so for this particular circuit, VD will be this value, ID will be this value, and depending on R, this value will change accordingly. Okay, this slope will change accordingly, this VD and ID will change. That is what we mean by that. So what happens is this particular, you know, range from this range from 0.7 to this will be very, very, very small. If it is 0.7 somewhere here, it's going to be 0.71 or 0.72 for that matter. It's very small because this is exponentially rising signal. Okay, so most of the times, see, either you have to solve it graphically or you have to solve it iteratively, no other go, right? So most of the times, to get simple solution, what we assume is the voltage dropped across the diode is going to be 0.7 or 0.65, which will be mostly given to you, okay, for a safer purpose. So for most of the cases in this particular course, you can assume VD to be approximately equal to 0.7 volt, and you will not be far from the actual answer. Okay, that is what I mean by approximating the diode voltage. So if I give a situation for the same circuit, if I say V is equal to, or this value is equal to 5.7 volt, V is equal to 5.7 volt, and then if I say R is equal to 5 kilo ohm, okay, how do you solve the circuit? What will be ID and what will be VD? Okay, how do you solve it? First of all, you need not go through this entire expression now again. If suppose you know you have to actually solve it, you will substitute 5.7 here, and you will substitute you know 5 kilo ohm here, and then you will try to solve for ID 5.7 here, and you have two unknowns and two equations. One is non-linear. You will have to solve it iteratively to get a answer, because it has implicit dependence on, you know, VD, or it has an exponential dependence on VD, right? So in that case, instead of going through this hefty process, because we have done this approximation of VD is equal to 0.7 volt, what I can do, I'll immediately assume this particular node voltage is 0.7 volt. So 5.7 volt minus ID is equal to, this current is 5.7 minus 0.7 divided by the resistance R, which is 5 kilo ohm. Okay, and this is 5 volt by 5 kilo ohm, which is nothing but 1 milliamps. 1 milliamps is flowing through the diode. So the actual solution VD comma ID is nothing but 0.7 volt comma, so the actual voltage VD comma ID is nothing but, for this circuit, VD comma ID is nothing but 0.7 volt, which we assume, comma 1 milliamps. Okay, that is the solution, and this is how we can easily solve any non-linear, or you know, the diode non-linear circuit involving diodes. Okay.